My name is Alp DiBirdi. I am the software product manager for 7250 IXR portfolio within ION IP routing division in Nokia. Today, I'm going to talk about 7250 IXR 10 and IXR 6, the new additions to the 7250 IXR portfolio. 7250 IXR 10 has 8 line card slots, IMM slots, with 2 CPM control cards. It is leveraging the traditional Nokia high availability infrastructure where we keep the TCP packets in sync between the active and the redundant control plane to ensure highest availability and non-stop routing. It also has 6 power supply slots plus 6 redundant ones when fully loaded to support feature evolution, but as well the chassis is designed ground up with the card pitch, with the depth to accommodate feature evolution of the forwarding chips. For 7250 IXR product family, we built chassis from ground up to ensure scalability and feature-proofing the solution. If we focus on the IXR 10 as an example, it has abundance of power supply options. First of all, it supports mix and match of AC and DC power supplies, and they are all modular. Fully loaded chassis is to take 6 power supplies, and we have 6 more slots for redundancy. You can offer 6+6 for full redundancy, maybe having an AC input and a DC input, fully having a redundant source of power supply, or you can have 6+1 redundancy in case of accommodating a failure. The same applies for the switch fabric. The switch fabric is not visible. It's at the back, right behind the fans. And there is enough switching capacity to accommodate 3.6 terabit on per line card basis. One other key attribute of 7250 is each and every IMM touches each and every switch fabric. Each and every switch fabric touches each and every switch IMM line card. It gives the full mix and match capability. It gives the ultimate flexibility when it comes to accommodating feature evolution of the 7250 product line. 7250 IXR makes use of SROS operating system, which gives us not only a rich feature set, but as well an interoperability capabilities together with symmetric multiprocessing, SMP. Nokia SMP is well ahead of the curve, such that each and every process, like BGP, is broken down into smaller processes and is run on different multi-core CPU. 7250 IXR 10, much like IXR 6, has 3.6 terabit capable line card slots. The first 2 line cards that are coming up with the first release is 36 port QSFP 2800 gig, which also supports breakout and 10 gig, 40 gig, and 25 gig optics options together with 50 gig optics permitting, plus a all starter configuration 48 port 10/1 gig SFP plus/SFP and 2 port QSFP 28, which again supports the breakout option. Each and every card is equipped with maximum buffers possible. At the end of the day, the box will be able to do the heavy lifting, will be able to absorb the burst to its maximum. Each and every forwarding chip is accompanied with 8 gigs of external memory for burst absorption capabilities for the worst case scenario. But as well, each and every one of these ports are MACSEC capable. Security is becoming a paramount concern to various operators, whether it's a data center, backhaul, mobile backhaul customer, and the box is designed ground up to ensure the most secure transport options that are available while making no compromise in the throughput. One other big capability feature of the 7250 is the synchronization. It supports SyncE plus 1588, both for frequency and phase on each and every one of the Ethernet ports in the 8 slots of IXR 10. The other addition to the 7250 IXR family of products is the IXR 6. IXR 6 shares the same IMMs, the line cards, and the control and processing module with the IXR 10. It also has 3.6 terabit slots, but also shares the very same operating system binary. So the capabilities that you would find throughout the IXR family of products would be identical. One other thing I would like to mention is the traffic management capabilities. IXR is the first product that supports hierarchical policing at ingress that gives us the ability to not only observe the burst, but also police it in multiple different tiers, not limited to per forwarding class, but more at a high level, at a crude level on per customer basis. IXR also with R6 is going to be the first product that supports hierarchical costs, multi-tier scheduling capability in the merchant silicon product line. Last but not least, it's also worth mentioning the advanced synchronization capabilities we talk about, the SyncE and 1588 for both frequency and phase is tied up to the OEM. The OEM timestamping for delay and jitter measurements is going to leverage the stringent timestamping abilities such that we will have a microsecond accurate OEM measurements capabilities throughout the 7250 IXR product family.